ఇప్పుడు మీకు చెప్తున్నాను ద మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ నెక్స్ట్ 45 మినిట్స్ ఎ వెరీ వెరీ పవర్ఫుల్ సెషన్. తర్వాత 15 మినిట్స్ ఇంటరాక్షన్, మీ క్వశ్చన్ ఆన్సర్స్ ఉంటుంది. దాని తర్వాత నా క్లాస్ మళ్ళీ కంటిన్యూ చేస్తాను. ఓకేనా? ఐ ఇన్వైట్ ఏ ట్రైనర్ పార్ ఎక్సలెన్స్, ఏ ట్రైనర్ నాట్ ఓన్లీ అబౌట్ ది ఎడ్యుకేషన్, ఈ లెర్న్డ్. ఇఫ్ యు లెర్న్ వాట్ యు డోంట్ నో, యు విల్ బికమ్ సంథింగ్ గ్రేట్. అంటే లెర్నింగ్ గురించి చెప్పడానికి వచ్చాడు. ఏం లెర్నింగ్? మీ చదువుతో పాటు ఇంకేం చేయాలి, ఇంకేం కోర్సులు తెలుసుకోవాలి, ఎటువంటి విషయాలు తెలుసుకోవడానికి, మీకు చెప్పడానికి, మన భాషలో చెప్పడానికి వచ్చాడు బెంగళూరు నుంచి నరేష్ ద ట్రైనర్. కంగ్రాచులేషన్స్ బాస్, వండర్ఫుల్. కిట్టన్న గారు ఫ్రమ్ బెంగళూరు, వారు చాలా పెద్ద ఇండస్ట్రియలిస్ట్, చాలా పెద్ద సార్. అమెరికాకు అనంతపురం హైదరాబాద్ పోయి చెట్టు పోయేస్తుంటారు సారు. వారు ఈరోజు మనను చూసి ఇటువంటి ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఎలా ఉందో చూడడానికి వచ్చినందుకు మీ అందరికి ధన్యవాదాలు సార్. థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్. ఓట్ టు నరేష్.
హలో. యా, గుడ్ 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 గుడ్, బట్ ఐఎమ్ నాట్ ఏబుల్ టు లిసన్ ఎనీ సౌండ్ ఫ్రమ్ ది బ్యాక్. హలో. జై హో. నో నో నో, జై హో. యా, హీ ఈజ్ ఎ చేంజ్ మేకర్. He's a change maker. Okay, once again, Jai Ho!
Jai Ho!
Good, good, good. Good strength. Now I realize that you had a good lunch. Okay. What is my topic? How to build your career. Okay? Again, I'll share the PowerPoint slides. I have beautiful PowerPoint slides with you. I'll share with you later. Nothing to worry about that. Okay. I'll speak in English mixed with Telugu and Telugu mixed with English. Is there any problem? Okay. Yeah. How many of you are very serious in career? Only few. So those who are interested can come front. Those who are not interested can leave the hall. How many are really serious in career? Want to know something about career? How to build your career? Okay, good. That's fantastic. Okay. First and the foremost thing, silence please. Yeah. First and the foremost thing, if you want to build a career, you should have some personality traits. What are those personality traits and how to build your career? I would like to explain you. Okay. I'll ask a simple question to you. There is a big mountain, okay? There is a big mountain in front of you. You have to climb that mountain. What all you need? Please raise your hands and answer. Yes? Sorry? Okay? I didn't get you. Okay? Then? Rope, okay? Sorry? Person, self-confidence. Oh, okay, good. Identify the person. Then? Plan. Beautiful. Then? Confidence. Yeah, we got the answer already, confidence. Anything else? Goal, okay? Training. Beautiful. Next? Enthusiasm. Fantastic. Actually, you know everything, but you are not using it. Teacher. Wow. First and the foremost thing, you need to have the mountain. That was the correct answer. You need to have the mountain. That means, if you want to build a career, you should know what type of career you want to build. It's very, very serious question to you. Are you serious about your career? You know what type of career you want to build. Have that clear picture with you. If you don't have the clear picture in building the career, you are going to land up in something else which you are not interested, and you'll land up in something else which you are not capable of. So have that 100% clarity in building the career. Do not say yes for something which you don't like. Do not say yes. Somebody said that, okay, X, the career counseling is all about identifying your potentiality. Identifying your potentiality. You go to any career counseling guide or coach, he will never give you a clear picture stating that, okay, you are good in MBA, you are good in CA, you are good in something else, do this, no. First thing which you have to identify is your potentiality. Your potentiality. What is your potentiality? Identify yourself. How to identify? There are various tests. Any one of the volunteer, physically fit, like me? Anybody? Yeah, please. I'll make you run 100 kilometers. Okay. Wait. This side. Come closer. How many you can? How many numbers?
50 plus.
Currently, 50 you can take?
Yes, sir.
Are you sure?
Yes,
sir. Okay, maximum?
Maximum, I don't know.
Okay, 10 you can take? 10, 15? 15, 1-5.
Yes, sir.
Okay. వీళ్ళు 15 సార్లు గుంజళ్ళు తీస్తారు. యూ హ్యావ్ టు కౌంట్ ది నంబర్ 1 to 15. హౌ మచ్ హీ కెన్ టేక్ నౌ? 15. విల్ స్టార్ట్. ఓకే, 1. You're done? Okay. How much I said? 15. Okay. You know 15 is not his capability. His capability is more than that. How much you want him to do that? Sorry? You had your lunch? Lunch? Sure? Okay. Can you take 20? 100? 50? I don't know, he should tell. 50? 50. He's asking 50.
I can, sir.
You can? You can? You want to try?
Sir,
you want to try or you want to do?
I know, sir. I can.
You can do. What you think you can is only one fixed value, but what is the capabilities is more than the fixed value. So now he says 15, he can do 15. If you want him to do 50, he's ready to do 50. And as soon as I asked him how many you can take, he said unlimited. He said unlimited. There was no actual quantification. Remember one thing. Your potentiality is more than what you think. If you target 150, you may get 100. But if you target 35, you may get 15. That's very important. So think big, and I say Abdul Kalam Gar Chopparu, they say you heard that in the first session, correct? Think always big. So identify your credentialities. Your good name?
Sir, Lavan Reddy.
Thank you very much, Reddy. I know that you can do 50. Okay. So, what is the first element which you have to understand? Identify your potentiality. So, the confidence level should be increased to the maximum possible. Put one more step ahead. Don't stop. Don't say that this is my possibility, because you are having the barrier in mind. You are having the barrier in what? Mind. Remove that little fence. Remove that little barrier, you will get abundant confidence. That's the first element which you need to have to build any kind of career. Can we bring that confidence now onwards? Yes? Forget anything. You are confident. You know that you can do. That's a belief system. Belief system, even if you take a stone and if you say that it is a god, it will become a god. That's the belief system. If you say that tree is a god, tree will become a god. If you say that you can do it. You can do it. There is no doubt about that. I'll tell you one small information to you. Please remember this. How to build your confidence level in the career. I have a big land. What is this? Big land. Okay. The land full, I mean, it is full of diamonds. How many of you want diamonds? Raise your hands if you want. Okay. The land is full of what? Diamonds. You should go and pick up the diamonds. It's yours. Nothing to pay. It's absolutely free. It's absolutely free. You can pick up any kind of diamonds. It's for you. Bag full of diamonds. Anybody offered like this to you? Okay. There is no hidden tactics here. There is only one small condition. There is only small condition. Whenever you are trying to pick up these diamonds, you should never see a white rabbit. What is this? White rabbit. If you see a white rabbit, diamonds will get converted into stones, pebbles. Is this fine? Correct? Now, what you have to do? Assume that this is a land of diamonds. You are picking up. What will hit your mind first? White rabbit. Absolutely, I know that. So that means white rabbit is not there, but it is there in your mind. That is called as your doubts. Your doubts on the confidence level. Ah, I cannot do this. Means start. It is not possible. You cannot do anything. So, in the land of diamonds, you should not search for white rabbit. Hey, white rabbit ostundi, I can't take this diamonds. Diamonds is there in front of you. Just pick up and put it. That's it. So, even if you have a small pinch of doubt, the white rabbit will make you not to pick the diamonds. You are getting the logic here? Yeah? So don't think of white rabbits. Start picking up your diamonds. Then you can build your confidence. That's the first thing which you need to have in the career. Second, you need to have a timepiece and a compass. What is this? Watch and a compass. You need to know what is time and which direction you are moving into. Time plus direction. Time is not sufficient alone. You should also know the direction where you are moving. A very good example is this. Today if you say that, how many of you are into information technology here? Just a quick question. Information technology, IT. Okay, very few of them. I am from IT background. I'll just give an example to you. I want to learn some basic language. How many of you know the C, C++, heard of it? Okay. I want to learn this particular language. Can I build a career on only that language? Can I build a career on only that particular essential foundation languages? Impossible. It was a hot package that time, but not now. So what is now? It is very important. Our education system in the country is different from what you need in the career. Do you agree with me? Yeah. The system is a foundation, that's it. But it cannot give you, or we cannot update the education system at par with the market. It's not possible. It's impossible to get the education system changed overnight, because the technology will get changed overnight. It cannot go concurrently. So in this case, which time, what you have to learn is very important for you. Correct? Suppose if you learn something which is not in the demand, and if you try to build the career, you'll be away from the career or the requirement, and I can say that it is a passion. Okay, something which is X, which you want to build a career, but it is not there in the market, it is only of passion or misguidance or the swap between yes or no question. You know, just jumped into that particular career without any knowledge. So, understand what is the time factor and collaborated with what is the direction. So you need to know the direction, you need to know the time. And once you realize this particular time, and then start proceeding through your career, then only you start. Because career is all about a process of few years. As Gampa sir always says that 3 years, 4 years, mere kashtapadandi, 8 years you'll be happy. You need not worry about remaining 80 years. And 3 years, 4 years, if you don't work hard, 8 years you'll be struggling. So this 3 years or 4 years is a foundation for you. So be aware of the time plus direction. Okay. Secondly, whenever you talk about time, very important, have time for everything and have everything in time. Can you repeat this please? Have time for everything and have everything in time. Meaning what? Sorry? Okay, we have two definitions here. Have time for everything means what? You divide the time for every aspect of your life. So much time I want to study, plan it. So much time I want to do something else. I want to go with sports. So much time I want to go with entertainment. So much time I want to be in Facebook. So much time I want to be in WhatsApp. Correct? So have time for everything. And have everything in what? Time. If you say that I want to go and study at 6 o'clock, yes, study at 6 o'clock. Keep some time for studying also. If you learn this faculty, it is very easy for you to build anything. This is a basic element, foundation for your career. Have everything in time and have everything in time and have time for everything. Okay? Very important for you. Next, be innovative. Have innovations through your career. How to identify the innovation? How to see the current market? Usually we don't look into the current market because we are not innovative enough. How to be innovative? Every day spend at least half an hour to 45 minutes to think something which is different. That is called as creativity. How to have that creativity? Change your habits. Change your habits. Change the route. Every day you are going to the college in the same route, change the route. Change the route, you will come to know how creative you are. So every day, don't do a routine task, at least half an hour to 45 minutes, change the routine task into a different task. Okay? So I was talking about the innovation and creativity. Every day spend at least half an hour to 45 minutes to think which is very much different in nature. Okay? Don't do the routine task by itself. So then your innovation will get improved and you will start discovering many things to build your career. Okay? That's very important task for you. Next, identifying the skills. We saw how to identify your potentiality, confidence we saw, correct? Now how to identify your skills? What skills makes you to build your careers? Very important question to you. How to identify your own skills? Can anybody help me? How to identify your own skills? How to identify? If you have skills. Sorry? Having a clear idea in what you know, okay? Hobbies, fantastic. That's a place where two things will come into the picture. One is creativity also. Next. Sorry? I didn't get you. Thinking, okay? How to identify, I'll repeat my question. How to identify that you have the skills in doing something? Okay.
ఎక్కువ దానిపైన వర్క్ చేస్తూ ఉంటే దానిపైన ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఉంది అని, దానిపైన స్కిల్స్ ఉంది అన్నమాట. ఓకే, బై ఎక్స్ప్రెసింగ్ టు అదర్స్. ఓకే, సాటిస్ఫాక్షన్ లెవెల్, యు ఆర్ గెటింగ్ ఆల్ బిగ్ బిగ్ వర్డ్స్. ఓకే, గుడ్. ప్యాషన్, క్రియేటివిటీ. ఓకే, ఐఎమ్ జస్ట్ ఆస్కింగ్ ఎ క్వశ్చన్, హౌ టు మెజర్ ఆర్ హౌ టు ఐడెంటిఫై యువర్ స్కిల్స్. టు ఐడెంటిఫై యువర్ స్కిల్స్, వాట్ ఎవర్ యూ సెడ్, సమ్ ఆఫ్ యూ ఈజ్ అబ్సల్యూట్లీ కరెక్ట్, చెక్ విత్ వాట్ ఈజ్ యువర్ హ్యాబిట్స్. ఓకే, అండ్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఎ పారామీటర్స్ క్వాడ్రంట్ విచ్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ స్వాట్. వాట్ ఈస్ వాట్? స్ట్రెంగ్త్, వీక్నెస్, ఆపర్చునిటీస్ అండ్ థ్రెట్స్. ఇఫ్ యూ గో విత్ ది స్వాట్ అనాలిసిస్, యూ విల్ కమ్ టు నో వాట్ ఈస్ యువర్ స్కిల్స్. యాజ్ సింపుల్ యాజ్ దిస్. So what is your strength? What is your strength? Identify your strength. How to identify? Look yourself. You're good in talking. You're good in logic. You're good in creativity. You're good in speaking. You're good in something else. That is your strength. It doesn't matter in which topic or which career you are interested in. But it is mandatory that you have to identify what is your skills. So to identify skills, the first test is SWOT analysis: strength, weakness, opportunities and threats. This is very much standard throughout the world. Even for any kind of project, you will go with SWOT analysis. But beyond the SWOT analysis, you also have something called as psychometric test. How many of you are aware of this? Psychometric test. Anybody aware of this? Okay. Today in any of the international organizations, even if you want to apply something, you have to go through this psychometric test. Psychometric test is very important today. Give you complete analysis of what you are into. So first is SWOT. Second is what? Psychometric analysis. Perform this particular test number of times on yourself. You'll identify and you can generate a report that this is my skills. So once you identify skills, it is very easy to understand which career suits you. It's very simple. Which career suits you depends upon how you identify your skills. Suppose if you are interested in one of the field, but you are weak in some of the strength, I mean you are weak in some of the, you know, values or maybe hobbies or the requirement for the careers, you can convert that particular weakness into strength very easily. Okay, there are many things which you can convert into strength. Okay, that's your test. Okay, next, I think they have time to go to bus or something. Okay, no problem. Next, there is one line which you have to understand. After identifying the skills, you need to have this P6. What is this? P6. P6 means proper prior preparation prevents poor performance. Can you repeat? Proper prior preparation prevents poor performance. What is P6? Yeah, anybody? Prevents poor performance. Okay, so if you are prepared, then the performance will be really good. If you are not prepared, the performance will not be good. So once you have identified the skills, start preparing towards that particular skills which can build your career. So analyze, this is called as collaborative studies. Collaborative means where to prepare, which should be aligned, how to prepare, it should be aligned to what career you are building. That's very important. So that is called as P6. P6. So you should have a prior preparation to prevent any kind of performance. Apart from identifying the skills, you also need to know many values which is related to the networking. How you can network and get the career done for you. For example, you want to build a career, you don't know anybody in that particular career, you'll be in darker side. You'll never know how to build the career at all. So suppose if I am interested in multimedia, for example, you should get collaborated to or network to some of the professionals who are already into the multimedia networking. So go with them, talk to them, get the information on multimedia and be a net worth for that. So networking is net worth. One more trait which you have to understand is networking is net worth. So network, network until you get your career boosted, okay, until unless you have the collaborative study. Okay, now talking about the certification, that's the second part of my subject. How many of you are interested in IT career, information technology? Anybody interested? Few of them? Okay. So, I'd like to guide you how to go with IT certifications. There are four divisions in IT. One is the software, hardware, networking and multimedia. There are four divisions. Okay. Who can select the software and what skills you need to have for the software? Anybody who has got the logic, what do you mean by logic? How to identify the logic? Sorry? Okay. How to identify whether you can apply the logic or not? Thinking, sorry? Okay. Reasoning, how do you get the reasoning? There are basically two elements for reasoning. Verbal and non-verbal, no. The logic all depends upon yes or no. Yes or no. The circuit of the electronic board is made up of 0 and 1, that is yes or no. Your logic will get improved only if you say yes or no. Yes is reasoning, somebody said reasoning, yes. So reasoning will get improved based upon yes or no. So if you want to choose a line which is software oriented, coding oriented, you need to know, improve on only one thing, when to say yes, when to say no. If you have the basic elements of yes or no, that means you're very good in logic. And if you're very good in logic, you can easily go to the software field. You'll be expertise in that. This is the basic element for your coding, simple logic in coding. The second type of certification or the field in the IT is hardware. Hardware, you need to have the knowledge of electronics purely. You need to know the electronics. Okay? So if you know the electronics, you can become the masters in the hardware. Otherwise, you'll land up in service engineer. You should know how to assemble a PC and come back. That's it. So if you are an electronic guy, if you are interested in electronics, then easily you can jump into the hardware. I'll also tell about the scope of each and every division. When you say software and when you have the logic to build the software, you can have a career where you'll be sitting and coding in front of system. You'll be coding day and night to get the output of a product or an application or a software. If you have the electronics knowledge, you'll be running around and working for the system repair or maybe chip level servicing or chip design also. That's the scope of your hardware. The third option in the IT career is networking. Networking, neither logic works here. You need not say yes or no for many things in networking. Or You need not have a complete electronic background. No need to go with electronics. For networking, you need only experience and common sense. It is purely experience. So how the way it is connected, how the systems are connected, what is the cloud? The connectivity starts from the basic electronics to the cloud level. Okay? So if you have a basic experience on networking, you can choose the networking. There is no need to apply logic here. It's a simple common sense. That's about networking. And if you talk about the scope of the networking, you will not sit in front of one place. You will be roaming around the world. You will be setting up various data centers. You will be connecting the systems. You may talk about WAN, you may talk about LAN, you may talk about something called as CAN or cloud, or you have various definitions. You will be roaming around the world. That is the scope of networking. And finally, when you talk about multimedia, neither logic works there, nor electronics, nor experience. You need to be 100% creativity. So when you say multimedia, you can develop a movie like Bahubali, okay? But you need to be creative enough like that. So identify your core values like this. This is the foundation values to build any kind of career. Any small core values of that particular career. I just gave an example of IT related career, how you can build the IT career. Okay? Similarly, in whatever field you want to select, identify that ice-breaking small source of that particular career, then you can say that, yes, I am in the right track. Okay? So, I just gave an example of information technology. Now, at the end, the scope of the multimedia is like this. You can develop any multimedia package, or you can work in the gaming industry, or you can work on any movie or studios for multimedia. These are four divisions. So start identifying the core element, basic element, to build your career. And this is about one of the trait or one of the value which you have to get through the career. Apart from this, when you talk about the preparations in the career, you should be connected, as I mentioned, time and direction, and you should have the knowledge. Knowledge is very important here. There are two values which I can say always. Always I will say this. Two things will constantly remain forever. One is knowledge, and one is communication. If you have the knowledge, then fine. If you have the communication, then also fine. But if you don't have both, you'll face problems. So, knowledge is very core value. Similarly, along with the knowledge, you need to have the communication skills also. If you have the knowledge and if you don't know how to present it, then it is of no use. Okay? And whenever you talk about knowledge and the communication skills, you need to develop your intelligence also. What is this? Intelligence. I hope every values you are recording here, which will be very useful for you to build a career or to build your life itself. Okay. What do you mean by intelligence? What is that smartness? Intelligence. And what makes you intelligent? Any? Yeah? Giving results in less time is an efficiency. Efficiency means what? Giving results in time. Say for example, you will take a vehicle. 1 liter of petrol, how many kilometers it will give is an efficiency. Less input, more output. What do you mean by intelligence? Application of knowledge? Let us keep that. Anybody else? Spontaneous reaction. Okay, it can be non-intelligent also. A spontaneous results, a spontaneous decision can be a non-intelligence. Okay, intelligence means a smart way of taking a decision. A smart way of taking a decision. For intelligence, somebody said knowledge. how to develop your intelligence, we have two things. You want to know about this? You have two things. If you develop this, your intelligence or smartness will develop always. What are these two things? One is increase your knowledge. Just increase your knowledge. If somebody is coming and sharing something with you, welcome. Welcome. At the tea time, somebody is sharing with you, please welcome the knowledge. Let it be any scrap knowledge. Just listen. More you listen, more you will become intelligent. First is knowledge. Correct? Second is experience. What is it? Experience. If there is a plug point here, I know that current is there. There is a power, electricity, that is a knowledge. And if I put a hand in, that is an experience. If you have both, then it is called as intelligence. You're getting this? So what should I need to have? Experience plus knowledge. While building your career, what you will do usually is, either you should have the knowledge, if I go with this particular path, will I succeed? Is it matching to me? Or speak to a person who is already experienced. So if you have knowledge plus experience, then intelligence will grow. You're getting this? Okay. Intelligence will grow. And please remember, the enemy of intelligence, emotions. Who is the enemy of intelligence? Emotions. When the door of emotions are opened, the door of intelligence will be closed. It's as simple as this. You're getting this? Okay. Don't be emotional, even though we are emotional being. Control that particular emotion, because emotions are always enemy to intelligence. It will not allow you to make any decisions. So you cannot be intelligent enough. Somebody said that, okay, you are not fit to get this particular salary. You'll be very emotional and say that, okay, I'll go and work for something and I'll get the money. Today you will get it, but tomorrow you'll suffer. Today you'll get it, tomorrow you'll suffer. A very good example for emotion and intelligence. Everybody knows Mahabharata here, right? Ramayana? Okay. Who was Dashratha? Okay, what was the major issue between King Dashratha and Rama? Correct. So Rama was sent to the forest. Why? Sorry? Yeah, because of Kaikeyi. Okay. What happened? There was a war where Kaikeyi was there and Dashratha was there. And suddenly the wheel of the chariot was broken and Kaikeyi will support and Dashratha will give the boons. I'll give you this. That was emotional actually. So in the emotional, the decisions were wrong. So emotionally, the three boons were given and suddenly Kaikeyi took, hey, it's my duty, don't worry, I am wife of you, it's my duty. She would have said, and Dashratha would have agreed, okay, it's your duty, and come out. Entire Ramayana would have not happened. Correct? Then what happened? Kaikeyi kept that boons, overall petkoni. Once they grew up, there was a clash between Rama and, who is the culprit in Ramayana, who made up the mind of Kaikeyi? Mandara. Yeah, there was an issue between Mandara and Rama. So that emotion was transferred to Kaikeyi. That emotion was transferred to Dashratha. Dashratha emotion was transferred to Rama. Rama emotion was transferred to Sita. When it was transferring to Sita, in between Lakshmana came. Even I will come to forest. He was just married couple. So what happens when the emotion grows, intelligence will be? You're getting the logic here? So when the emotion is controlled, the intelligence will boost up. Absolutely it will boost up. I'll tell you one more traits here, which is fear. Usually, Bayam, how many of you have fear? I had, and I know that it's a state of mind. What is fear? Frightening, okay. When you're building the career, don't be afraid of anything in the world. Don't be afraid of anything, fear. False evidence accepted as reality. It's a false evidence accepted as reality. It's a state in mind. It's state in mind. Okay? So, avoid this particular fear because it's only a state. It is only a state in mind. The fear will not come out of any things or situations. None of the situations will give you the fearness. Okay? If you have fear, you cannot go forward. That's very important. You'll develop an inferiority complex when you have the fear, and that inferiority will lead into a complex, very big complex. Even if you have the skills, you will not move forward in career. It will trouble you. Okay? And there are two more things. Yeah. There are two more things which you have to understand. Last two things. Listening and appreciation. Very important. Listening and appreciation. You need to listen to the things, the career, or whenever you are building career or to whatever you are getting in to build your knowledge. Listening is very important. And you need to know how to appreciate also. A very quick example, Lord Hanuman didn't listen what was explained by the doctor when Lakshmana was in coma state. Okay, he didn't listen. So the doctor is telling, okay, do something, mix something, etc. Already Hanuman is flying. He didn't listen. Whenever you don't listen, there will be a lot of confusion. Hanuman went to the, where? Himalayas. And he was confused what to get, how to get. Because he was not listening. He saw the entire Himalaya, but he didn't know how to pick that. Finally, he was able to pick up the entire mountain. How? He started self-appreciation. If there was no appreciation, he would have not grown bigger. Correct? He would have not grown bigger. So once you appreciate yourself, the problems will become very small and you can lift the problem very easily. Okay? So have that listening to avoid any kind of confusion and have that self-appreciation to lift any kind of mountain. Okay? So these are some of the personality traits, and I gave an example of IT certification, like what are the classifications which you need to have in the IT certifications. Okay? Have that self-appreciation, have that listening skills, have that intelligence, have that confidence, have that time, have that direction, and identify your skills, test your skills, and move with the confidence. I wish you all the best for your career. Thank you. Any questions? Can I take the questions, sir? One or two? Any questions you can ask me? 2 to 3 questions. There are two things. If you don't have a question, I should understand that you understood nothing or you understood everything. So what should I feel now? You understood everything? So somebody didn't understand anything. Yes. Sorry? How to goal? I think we have a topic on goal setting. How to fix a goal? There'll be a topic on goal setting. Yes, I love to take that, but there are many topics in the pool. I was given more about career. Okay? So it's an important question. Be with this presentations. How to set a goal? It will be presented by some trainer. Any question? Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. All the best for you.
Now, I would like to thank and acknowledge Naresh Garu for coming all the way from Bangalore to give this wonderful class. Your number
My number is, I'll repeat, 99456. 66456. Okay? You can remember easily. Thank you.
Email.
BabuDynamic@gmail.com. I'll repeat, BabuDynamic, BabuDynamic@gmail.com. Website is NareshBabu.in, www.NareshBabu.in. Okay. You can send a mail. I'll reply with the PowerPoint presentation. There's a beautiful PowerPoint presentation related to the career or different subjects. Thank you. Question? Yep. Security is not there in IT field. No, who said it? Security is there in IT field. It is not the question of field itself. You're asking about technology, you're asking about field itself. Okay. I'll tell you, I'll address. The entire information technology business, please listen, the entire information technology business depends upon how active the human being is. If the day comes where you are highly active, do your work without depending on the system, then the IT industry will get collapsed. So meaning, there is a growth rate in the information technology always, and the entire world, only 30 to 35% is digitalized. Remaining entire process is still manual. So that means you have a scope in IT, you have to find the right technology, right timings, with right product. Then you have the scope in the IT. That's it.
Innara, Naresh Gardi. So, phone jeshi migita vishyal telusukondi. Okay. Thank you, Naresh. So nice of you. Good luck. All the best, Naresh.